basic mathematics. So this is related to numerical ability in our quantitative aptitude section. So here we will discuss divisibility rules, multiplication rules, sum of numbers, sum of squares of natural numbers, and etc. So before going to this, let us discuss the basic number system. Our number system starts with natural numbers. Natural numbers are called counting numbers. If you want to count something, we will start with 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. The natural number starts with 1, 2, 3, and so on, infinite. Natural numbers, along with 0, they are called whole numbers. Whole numbers represented with W. On top of it, we will have integers. Integers in the sense minus infinity to plus infinity, including 0. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, they are called positive integers. And along with this, negative numbers like minus infinity to minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So all together, they are called integers. Integers denoted with Z. Z plus in the sense positive integers, Z minus in the sense negative integers. On top of it, we will have real number system. Real number system also denoted by minus infinity to 0, 0 to plus infinity. But when it comes to mathematical representation, we are saying Z and R both as minus infinity to 0, 0 to plus infinity. Symbolic representation is same for both. But ideally, the difference between both is in between 1 and 2. In layman terminology, if you want to understand Z and R, in between 1 and 2, there exists no number in set integers. After 1, immediately we will have 2. But the same in real number system, in between 1 and 2, we can form infinite numbers. Real number system is combination of both rational numbers and irrational numbers. What do you mean by rational and irrational? Rational numbers in the sense, numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q, where P comma Q belongs to integers and Q not equal to 0. Numbers which form this particular representation, they are called irrational rational numbers. Irrational numbers in the sense, numbers which cannot be written in the form of P by Q are called irrational. So the combination of rational and irrational itself is real number system. So in layman terminology, in between 1 and 2, we can form infinite numbers here. How? After 1, we may get 1.00001, 1.00002, like that, 1.99999, and so on. So there will be infinite numbers in between 1 and 2 in real number system. But whereas in integers, there exists no number between 1 and 2. This is the basic terminology. And you all know that even numbers, odd numbers, prime numbers, prime number in the sense numbers which have only two factors, that is number 1 and number itself. For example, 2. 2 is divisible by only 1 and 2. So these two are called factors. So numbers which has only two factors, 1 and number itself, other than these two, there should not be any factor. They are called prime numbers. Take an example, 3. 3 is also divisible by exactly 1 and 3. When you consider 4, 4 has 1, 2, 4. 4 is divisible by 1 and 2 and 4. So here we have more than two factors. So 4 is not called a prime number. Numbers which has 1 and itself as factors, they are called prime numbers. Now when you talk about co-prime numbers in the sense, they need not to be prime numbers. They need not to be prime numbers. Numbers having no common factor. There should not be any common factor other than 1. Other than 1. It is about factor 1, not number of factors. Numbers having no common factor other than 1 are called coprime numbers. Coprime numbers need not to be prime numbers. Take an example. 4 and 9 we have. These two are coprime numbers. Why are we calling them? Factors of 1, if you observe, they are 1, 2 and 4. And when it comes to 9, factors are 1, 3, 9. Now, out of these factors, common factors are only 1. So these two are numbers which has only one common factor, and that is only 1. Hence, these two can be called coprime numbers. And there is one more thing. Simply we can say numbers whose HCF is equal to 1, they are called coprime numbers. We will discuss more about this in LCM and HCF chapter. For now, just remember coprime numbers will have HCF 1. And any two consecutive numbers are also called coprime numbers. Any two consecutive numbers. Take any example in your number system. 4, 5, 9, 10, or maybe 109 and 110. So any two consecutive numbers are coprime numbers because they will not have any common factor other than 1. Now, they will ask you to calculate sum of natural numbers, sum of squares of natural numbers, sum of cubes of natural numbers. We will discuss one by one. Sum of natural numbers in the sense n into n plus 1 by 2. Here, n value is last digit or last number provided if starts with 1. Your series must start with number 1. Then only we can take n is equal to last number. If it is not starting with 1, how to consider this? We will discuss one by one. Now let's start our first question in basic mathematics. Find the sum of all natural numbers from 1 to 15. Observe your series, whether it is starting with first natural number or not. Yes, as it is starting with first natural number, our n value is last digit. Hence, n is equal to 15. N into n plus 1 by 2. 2, 8 times, 15, 8 times, 120, first option. Suppose if the series is not starting with 1, which is our first natural number, how to solve this question? Let's see here. The same question, but when you observe your first number, it is not starting with first natural number. Now for these type of questions, how to calculate? Come on, let's see. For these type of questions, take statement like this. Sum of numbers from 1 to 20. But as we are looking for sum of numbers from 10 to 20, before 10, whatever number we have, till that number, we have to subtract their sum. So from 1 to 9, whatever sum will be there, we have to subtract. From this, subtract sum of numbers from 1 to 9. Do remember, we need 10. In our sum of numbers, we need 10. Before 10, whatever number we have, till that number, we have to take subtraction. Here, starting with first natural number. Here also starting with first natural number. So sum of these numbers becomes n into n plus 1 by 2 minus n into n plus 1 by 2. 2, 5 times here. 2, 10 times here. Answer is 2, 10 minus 9, 5 is 45. Answer is 165. 165 is our second option. So if it is the series starting from first natural number, directly we can consider n is equal to last number. Otherwise, we have to consider statement like this. Now, our second model is sum of even numbers. Sum of even numbers in the sense n into n plus 1. But here n is equal to last number divided by 2. N is equal to last number by 2. Here also the series must start with first even number. Here for previous question we discussed it has to start with the first natural number because you are asked to calculate sum of natural numbers. But now you are asked to calculate sum of even numbers. Sum of even numbers. So it has to start with first even number. But observe the question. Is that question about sum of numbers from first even, that is 2, 4, 6 up to 30, or 30 even numbers? Both the questions are different. 30 even numbers, first 30 even numbers, both the questions meaning is different. When you have numbers from 2, 4, 6 and so on 30, in this particular set there are only 15 even numbers starting with first even number. But if you are asked to calculate 30 even numbers from 2, 2 must be treated as first even, 4 must be treated as second even, third even, 15th even, like that 30 even numbers. Your question is very important. Find the sum of first 30 even numbers. So how many even numbers are there? There are 30 even numbers, so n value is direct 30. Because here n is equal to last number by 2, in the sense there we are calculating how many even numbers are there. When you have numbers from 2, 4, 6 and so on 30, out of 30 numbers, exactly 50% numbers are even numbers and 50% are odd numbers. Hence we are taking by 2 to identify how many even numbers are there. But now clearly they are saying there are 30 even numbers, n value is equal to 30. Our sum of numbers is n into n plus 1. 30 into 31, which is equal to 930, first option, final answer. Now the second one, find the sum of even numbers from 2 to 20. Even numbers from 2 to 20. So here we have set, number set range 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on 20. Now in this particular case n value is equal to last number by 2. When the n value is equal to last number by 2, that is equal to 10, our answer is n into n plus 1. N plus 1 in the sense 10 plus 1, that is equal to 11. 10 into 11, 110, second option answer. Now the similar series like we discussed for question number 2, sum of all the natural numbers from 10 to 20, whatever logic we applied here, similar logic we will apply here also. Find the sum of even numbers from 18 to 26. So how to calculate? Let us consider sum of even numbers from 2 to 36, but we need sum of numbers from 18 to 36. Before 18, whatever even number we have, that was 16. From first even number, which is 2, to 16, we have to subtract. 2 to 16, we have to subtract. Now here n value is equal to last number by 2, which is 18. And here n value is equal to last number by 2, 8. Now n into n plus 1, 18 into 19, and here n is equal to n into n plus 1, 8 into 9. How to calculate product of this? Now when you have sum of product of consecutive numbers, product of consecutive numbers, 18 into 19, let me tell you simplification. One is traditional way, which we don't use. When you have numbers like this, small number square plus a small number is one way. Otherwise, big number square minus big number, that is another way. Or else, 18 into 19, treat this 19 as 20 minus 1. 18 into 20 minus 18 into 1. we are taking 18 20 times and subtracting one time. Finally, that will become 19 times. 18 20 is in the sense 360. From 360, if you subtract 18, you will get 342. Otherwise, 18 square 324 plus 18 342. 19 square 361 minus 19 342. There are multiple ways to answer the question. Now, finally, 18 into 19, the value is equal to 342. So from 342, we have to subtract 8 nines, that is 72. Again, even in these particular cases also, apart from 300, we have 42. Subtract 42 first. Then again, we have to subtract 30 more from 300. From 300, if you subtract 30, the value is equal to 270. Third option is our final answer. This class is as part of Sridhar CC's online batch 2. To watch full video course, log on to www.sridharcc.com/online-course. Subjects covered in this batch are useful for all competitive examination which a graduate can write in India. Reasoning, quantitative aptitude, general English, current affairs, computer awareness, and banking awareness. We are going to cover all these subjects in two different levels, basic level and advanced level. Basic level is useful for preliminary examination. Advanced level is useful for mains level. The batch includes 450 plus hours of classroom teaching and 150 plus hours for topic-wise test explanation. Medium of teaching, classes and explanation completely in English medium. PDF material will be provided in English medium. Topic-wise test for each and every subject, including each and every topic, will be conducted. And there are three packages available. The major 3 months, 6 months, and then 12 months packages are available. In 3 months structure, you'll get 450 hours plus classroom teaching, PDF copies, topic-wise test on all chapters, monthly model test and explanation, special live classes access for 3 months, 3 months current affairs, including PDF, and student can watch all the above videos for n number of times. Apart from this, every Wednesday we will conduct preliminary examination. In 3 months period, you'll get 12 to 13 preliminary examinations followed by explanations. And every second Sunday and fourth Sunday, we will conduct mains examination. In 3 months, we can write 6 mains level exams. In 6 months course, you'll get 450 plus hours teaching, PDF copies, topic-wise test for all chapters, monthly model test and explanation, special live classes access for 6 months, and 6 months current affairs including PDF copies, and student can watch all the above for n number of times. In 6 months, you can write 24 to 26 preliminary examinations and 12 mains examinations. In 12 months course, special live classes access for 12 months will be there, 12 months current affairs will be there, and n number of times you can watch preliminary exams, 48 to 52 exams you can write, and there are 24 mains examination and each exam followed by explanation. 450 hours plus teaching, PDF copies, along with PDF copies for 12 months course, we will send printed material to your home. If you have any queries, please contact us on 950-44-3333 or mail us on online.sridharcc@gmail.com.